What is going on, guys? This is Green Storm Tornado with part 2 of the 4th episode of the series, My Way to Play Minecraft. So, as you can see, I'm in the cave that I mentioned in the previous video, or in the rail system. And oh boy, are you in for a treat here. Yeah, it's true. I feel so energetic today. I just had to make this video. And as you can see here, I found this nice love chest that I took everything from. And I'm going to... So here are the rails. I do not know for sure if I take these rails or not. I think I did because... I mean, they're very needful. But yeah, here's lava. I didn't take lava with me, actually. No. I don't quite need it, but when I'll need it, you'll see. I'll just go into this rail system and just pick the lava up. But this time, as you can see, there's more iron, and this was such a great cave. Oh man, it was. What I wanted to talk about. There's so much to talk about. Okay, let's just get to the topic. Okay, so I am watching. Just a moment, guys. This is the part where I found diamonds, and as you can saw, I hope clearly, there was diamonds just right there on this cliffside, and it was so dangerous out there. And when I was clumsy, oh man, one diamond fell into the lava. Oh man, that was a painful thing to watch, and you couldn't do anything about it. I mean, what would you do? Roast into lava? That won't help. You wouldn't even get your diamond back. How's that for fair? Alright. So here I'm building a pathway to diamond, and I found like these 6 diamonds. So good. I don't pick this coal up. As you can see, we're getting closer to 9. And I was so scared right there. I thought this bet is gonna push me off. I don't think they can do that, actually. but anyway. Let's just get to the topic, shall we? I was watching the Blind Film Critic channel. And, you know, Tommy Edison, right? He's been blind since birth. He's a really, really energetic guy. He's really funny guy. Vsauce actually inspired me to watch him. So here the diamond fell off. But anyway, they actually inspired me to watch Tommy Edison, and boy, were they right when they said that it's a great channel. What he does is he describes what it's like to be blind and stuff, and he also describes, you know, he also answers the questions that people would like to know and ask the blind film critic. It's a very well made channel. You know, when I found out about Tommy Edison, I thought, oh man, this is definitely not gonna be a great channel. This is going to be, you know, a blind person just bitching about his problems. But boy, was I wrong. And Thank God I was, because it's a great channel. I mean, you should really check it out. It's called the Tommy Edison XP channel, or the Blind Film Critic. And he, you know, does stuff like how to make food for himself and stuff like that, which is really, really good. I mean, I could not believe it with my own eyes when I saw it. But it's a really, really well-made channel. I mean, you know, he's very lucky. He's a very lucky man to have the camera crew and stuff like that. And another thing, right, guys? How do blind people? What do blind people see? I mean, the obvious answer would be black. I mean, because, you know, when you have your eyes closed and you don't see anything, you see black. But they don't see black. They see nothing at all. That's the right question. They see nothing at all. And that's an interesting thing. What do you see when you see absolutely nothing at all? Not even black. What is the thing that you see? I don't know. Oh man, I don't know. This is just it's incredible to think about, actually. Wow. It blew my mind away when he said, "I don't see black. I see nothing. I see nothingness." So yeah. But wow. That's a big topic, actually. Well, let's just get to my Minecraft topic, shall we? Like I said in the part 1, do not expect the blog video to be the next video I make. It'll actually be the 5th episode of the series. And, yeah. So, here, just make another furnace to use, and you can probably hear in my voice that I'm pretty sick. I'm ill. I have a flu of some sort. Not a swine flu or something like that, or a bird flu or something like that. The bird flu is really popular around here. But no, I actually have just a normal flu, you know. It's not too bad. I'm gonna get over it eventually. But yeah. So here I'm just stacking up stuff and in my chest. I don't know what is actually to do here, except to plant the melon seeds that I picked up and stuff. So, this episode is a really good episode, actually. This was, of course, supposed to be a live commentary episode, but turns out I didn't double-check Frap's settings in order to see the mistakes and stuff like that. So I couldn't actually see that my microphone is muted. Oh man, that was stupid of me. But I mean, the non-life commentary works just great as well, I guess. I mean, you know, from the part that I made a really, really good live commentary, but it just makes the non-commentary a little better. I mean, I could still improve and stuff, but it was pretty good for the 4th episode. I mean, it was really, really good. I don't know what to talk about, guys. I really am out of topics right now. I'm out. I'm clean. I'm out. I'm down and out. I don't know. What to talk about? Hmm. I don't know. Well, this video is going to go to the close. Just 2 minutes left in this video. And I guess... Oh, 4 minutes. Sorry. So, here, I'm just going to expand this farm here. So, plant these melon seeds down. And, what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to use bone meal for these melon seeds in order for them to grow. I do not know why this isn't called watermelon seeds and the plant isn't called watermelon, because melon is a totally different fruit, actually, come to think about it. I mean, it's kind of similar, and the taste is just not the same. They actually come from the same family, but the taste is just not the same. I mean, I like the watermelon a lot better than I like the melon, but that's just my personal preference, I guess. I don't know what to talk about in this video. What was I actually searching for? Nothing, I think. What I actually wanted to go for are some more sheep. But I did not find the sheep, actually. yeah, I don't know. It's a nice terrain, though I don't find sheep. I actually cook the cactus into cactus green, as you will see, but yeah, I don't do anything like more interesting. That was when I found diamond. This was the top of my commentary right there. I mean, what more do you want than, you know, finding diamonds and stuff? So here I just looking for some seeds right here. To plant. So here I'm actually going to, no, I thought I was going to fall down here, but I actually didn't, which is really nice. This is actually very, very good. It's a very, very good video. I hopefully you guys will hopefully appreciate my effort. I mean, I'm still improving. And here I was talking about, as you could saw, I had a shaky mouse. What I actually was doing here is actually showing you where I'm going to patch the terrain, and because you know, the terrain is pretty much, you know, I have to patch this cave. I have to, otherwise I'll fall down most of the time, and that just wouldn't be good. But here I'm just picking up the whole iron. Here. I'm just going to transform cactus green. I got five, so I need three more, right? So I'm just going to pick up this cactus right here and another two right about here. So what I could actually do in another video is make something out of the very easy to find material, sand. Right there, right here, which I have tons of, which you can see I'm in a desert. So it's a good thing I'm in a desert as well. So yeah, what I can actually do is actually make a cactus farm in order to protect me from most mobs and stuff like that. I don't know, that's all in the future, and I hope in the near future videos. But yeah, guys, so comment, rate, and subscribe, and I'll see y'all later.